Darwin is the capital city of Australia's northernmost territory, also known as the Top End. As many as 2,500 U.S. Marines will live and train there by 2017. They will make up a rotational force authorized in a 2011 pact between the U.S. and Australia. The military buildup is projected to pour more than $5 billion into the Darwin economy, and representatives from the Northern Territory's business community are here seeking insight from their Guam counterparts. Greg Bicknell is the CEO of the Darwin Chamber of Commerce.
We're seeing that there's some valuable lessons in the construction, the long supply lines, how the Armed Forces Committee has actually engaged with defence here. I think there's some really good lessons for us. We have long supply lines like you have in Guam from mainland USA. So we're looking at how some of those things are handled and some of the opportunities for business that spill out the side of those supply lines.
More than 1,000 Marines are already living and training in Darwin, which has had a long-standing presence of Australian military bases and troops. But like Guam, residents have still raised various concerns over the large influx of Marines.
We're continually working to set people's minds at rest that some of these developments aren't going to have the environmental impacts that there's a bit of scaremongering about. So they're the sort of social and cultural issues that we're keen to see that have been explored and successfully explored here.
Then there are concerns that the so-called U.S. pivot to Asia Pacific and the presence of American troops in Australia could raise tensions with an emerging world power in China. But Bicknell says he's witnessed more cooperation among the countries of late, not less.
We've actually seen recently a joint U.S.-Australian-China exercise, military exercise in the top end. So I think even though there's some saber rattling, I think there's actually some good engagement across those three countries.
For Guam's News Network, I'm Nestor LeConto.